In chapter tangents and secants, so far we completed the theory related to finding the area of a segment of a circle. Now the problems based on this theory. See exercise 9.3, the first problem, it is important in the exam point of view for 4 marks. In a circle of radius 10 cm, a curd subtends a right angle at the center. Find the area of the corresponding first one minor segment and the second one major segment. So you have to find out both the areas of minor segment and major segment. See the question in the diagram, it is given the circle with the center O and radius of the circle is given 10 centimeters and the both the radius of 10 centimeters and the curd subtends a right angle at the center, means the angle between these radii is 90 degrees. So this is a curd AB, OA and OB are the radii of the circle of length 10 centimeters and AB is the curd. So angle between the radii is 90 degrees. So we have to find out the area of the minor segment and the major segment. So first write the given data. See the solution, given radius of the circle, radius r equal to 10 centimeters and the angle, substitute the angle, so angle x degrees is equal to 90 degrees. Now find the one by one, first area of the triangle here OAB, find area of the right angle triangle, right angle at O, so AOB. So find out one by one area of right angle triangle AOB. So what is the area of right angle triangle? So we already completed the formula. Area of the right angle triangle equal to half into product of the sides at right angle. Half into product of the sides at right angle. So half into product of the sides at right angle means observe here the right angle at O. The sides at right angle is OA and OB. So product of the sides at right angle. So half into OA into OB. Because the right angle at O, the sides are OA and OB. Half into OA value 10 centimeters, OB value 10 centimeters. So 2 1s are 2 5s are. Cancel 2 1s are 2 5s are. 5 into 10, 50 centimeters. 5 into 10, 50 centimeter square, because it is area of the triangle OAB, area of the triangle AOB equal to 50 centimeter square. Next, find area of the circle, area of the circle, the second one, area of the given circle, area of the circle. So area of the circle formula, pi r square. Area of the circle formula pi r square. So pi value is given, the question, use pi as 3.14, use pi as 3.14. so 3.14 into r value, r means radius of the circle, it is given 10 centimeter. So r square means 2 times 10 into 10, 10 square. Now 3.14 as it is, 10 into 10, 10 square, 10 square means 100. Now multiply 3.14 into 100 for the two zeros. The decimal point moves left to right two digits. For two zeros means nothing but 100. If you multiply 3.14 into 100, the decimal point moves two places, one, two, two places for two zeros. So this answer is 314 centimeter square. Area of the circle 314 centimeter square. Now same, find the area of the sector, area of the sector OAPB, area of the sector. Next, area of sector, area of sector OAPB, OAPB, area of this sector formula, area of sector formula x degrees by 360 into pi r square, x degrees by 360 into pi r square. Now this is area of the sector formula. Now substitute one by one. X degrees means angle here, x equal to 90 degrees, 90 by 360 into pi value, it is given 3.14 into r square. R means radius of the circle, that is 10 square. So cancel, 9 ones are 90 ones are 94 360. So here 1 by 4 into 3.14 into 10 square means 100. The same process, 3.14 into 100, 3.14 into 100 value 314. So 314 by 4. 1 into 314 means 314 by 4. Now, 314 by 4 value 78.5 centimeter square, because it is an area. So area of the circle, complete circle, is 314. Area of the triangle is 50 centimeter square, and area of the sector OAPB is 78.5 centimeter square. Now we have to find out minor segment area and major segment area. Now first one, minor segment, area of minor segment. Area of minor segment equal to area of the sector. Area of the sector. Area of the sector OAPB. Area of the sector OAPB minus area of the triangle AOB. Area of the triangle, right angle triangle AOB. So this is the formula. See, once again, area of the minor segment, we have to find out the shaded portion. See, the blue color shaded portion APP, this is minor segment. Complete the shaded portion is minor segment. We have to find out this area of the minor segment. For this, see, the complete area of the sector, complete sector OAPB, complete area of the sector minus remove the area of the triangle, then only we get the area of the minor segment. Once again, area of the sector OAPB minus area of the triangle, right angle triangle AOB. Remove this area from the complete sector, then we get this shaded portion area, that is our required minor segment. So area of the sector, we already calculated the area of the sector 78.5 minus area of the right angle triangle AOB equal to 50. So 78.5 minus area of the triangle AOB is 50. 78.5 minus 50 equal to 28.5 centimeter square. So this is area of the minor segment. Now area of the major segment. See, area, how to find out the area of the major segment? Here the major segment is AQB. See, complete circle, so remove the area of the minor segment. See, if you remove this minor segment area, then we get the area of the major segment. So major segment AQB is the major segment, and the minor segment is APB. So from complete the area of the circle, if you remove the area of the minor segment, if you remove this portion area, then we get area of the complete major segment. So formula of the area of major segment is area of the circle minus area of the minor segment. So formula, area of major segment, area of major segment equal to area of the circle, area of the circle minus area of the minor segment, area of the minor segment. See, once again, area of the major segment equal to area of the circle minus area of the minor segment. So area of the circle, area of the circle equal to 314, area of the circle 314 minus area of the minor segment. Just now find out area of the minor segment is 28.5, is 28.5. So 314 minus 28.5 equal to 285.5 centimeter square, 285.5 centimeter square. Now this is area of the major segment. Now see second problem. In a circle of radius 12 centimeter, a curved substance an angle 120 degrees at the center. Find the area of the corresponding minor segment of the circle. And here pi value given 3.14, root 3 value is given 1.732. It is similar to same example 1 before exercise 9.3, example 1, exactly same. The only small change is in example here the radius of the circle is 21 centimeters, but in exercise problem it is 12 centimeters. Complete same exam, exactly same problem. See in the question, in the diagram, here the circle and the radius of the circle is given 12 centimeters. Here the AB is the curd. It substance an angle 120 degrees, means the angle between the radii is 120 degrees. We have to find out area of the minor segment. Area of the minor segment. Minor segment means AXB. This is the shaded portion, the blue colored shaded portion area we have to find out. Same as first problem. But here in the first problem, the angle between the radii is 90 degrees, means that the triangle is a right angle triangle. But this is not a right angle triangle, it is an obtuse angle triangle. So how to find out the area of this triangle? Means same, half into base into height. Now first write the given data. See the solution. So given radius of the circle, radius of the circle r equal to, it is given 12 centimeter, and next angle is given, angle x degrees is equal to 120 degrees. Now see, find the area of the sector, area of the sector OAXB. Complete the area of the sector. So first area of the sector OAXB, area of the sector OAXB equal to formula x degrees by 360 into pi r square. Area of the sector formula x degrees by 360 into pi r square. Now substitute the values. X degrees means 120 degrees by 360 into pi value, it is given in the question 3.14 into r, r value radius of the circle 12, so 12 square. Now cancel in 120 table, 120 ones are 120 threes are, 120 table means nothing but 12 table, 12 ones are 12 threes are 36. So here one time and three times. Next, so right here 1 by 3 into 3.14 into 12 square, 12 square value 144, 12 square value 144. Now cancel in 3 table, 3 ones are, next 3 fours are 12, 2 remaining 24, 24 means 3 eights are 24. Now area, the required area is equal to numerator value 3.14, 3.14 into 48, 3.14 into 48 equal to 150.72 centimeter square. So area of the sector OAXB equal to 150.72 centimeter square. Now we have to find out the area of the triangle OAB. So how to find out area of this triangle?
Area of the triangle means half into base into height. So we have to find out the base measurement AB and height of this circle. So how to find out the base and height of the circle? So here we have a method with the help of trigonometric ratios. We can find out the height and base of the triangle. See how to find out. Now see, finding area of triangle OAB. Now for this, what we have to do? See here, OAB is the triangle. So here, same triangle. Now for this, draw a perpendicular bisector of curved AB. So here observe one thing. Perpendicular bisector of any curve is always passing through its center of the circle. Perpendicular bisector of any curve always passing through the center of the circle. So this curve, the perpendicular bisector of the curve, suppose it is OM. The OM means the curve, the perpendicular bisector always passing through the center. So like this. So this is a perpendicular bisector of the curve AB. I am denoting the point with M. So see the same diagram here. Here this is OM is a perpendicular bisector of the curve, and here the angle at M is 90 degrees. Angle at M is 90 degrees, and it is M is a midpoint of AB. M is a midpoint of curve AB because it is a perpendicular and bisector. Perpendicular means angle here at 90 degrees. Bisector means divide AB into two equal parts. And observe here one more thing. The OM, here the perpendicular bisector, is also angular bisector of angle O. This line is angular bisector of angle O. Here, angle at center. Angular bisector means dividing the angle exactly two equal parts. So here the 120 is divided into two equal parts, 60 and 60. So here it is 60. And same here also 60. 60 plus 60, 120. So OM is a perpendicular bisector of AB, as well as it is a perpendicular angular bisector of angle O. Angular bisector of at angle O means angle O is divided here, AOB divided into two equal parts, the angle 60 and 60. Now what about the triangle OMA? OMA. OMA is a right angle triangle because angle at M is 90 degrees. It is a perpendicular to AB. So angle at M is 90 degrees. So OMA, a triangle, is right angle triangle. So write the complete information here. OM is a perpendicular bisector of curved AB. Perpendicular bisector of curved AB means OM is perpendicular to AB, and also M is the midpoint of curved AB means AM is same as BM. A to M distance, M to B distance is same, and both are equal to half of the AB. Both are equal to half of the AB. AM, BM, both are same, and both are equal to half of the length, complete length of AB. And also OM is an angular bisector of angle AOB. OM is angular bisector of angle AOB. Angular bisector of angle AOB. Then here the angle AOM. Angle AOM equal to angle BOM. Angle BOM. See the left side triangle AOM and the right side triangle BOM. The angle at O is divided into equal parts 60 and 60. Now in right angle triangle OMA. in right angle triangle OMA. Now apply the concept of trigonometry. We have to find out here, this is the height of the triangle. This OM is the height of the triangle AOB, and AB is the base of the triangle. AB is the base of the triangle. So we have to find out OM and AB with the help of trigonometric ratios. So it is a right angle triangle. So we can apply the trigonometric ratios, and angle here at 60 degrees. Here this is the angle at 60 degrees. So for this angle, the side AM, for this angle, the side AM is opposite side. For this angle, it is opposite side. And OM is adjacent side. And the side OA is opposite to right angle. So it is hypotenuse. And the length of OA is given, that is 12 centimeters, nothing but it is the radius of the circle. See, once again, angle at here is 60 degrees, its opposite side is AM, adjacent side is OM, hypotenuse is OA. Now apply trigonometric ratios, we have to find out OA, we have to find out OM and AB. So first take the cos 60 degrees, so cos A formula, adjacent side by hypotenuse, so write adjacent side by hypotenuse. So adjacent side is OM by hypotenuse is OA, hypotenuse value OA, adjacent side OM, hypotenuse OA. Cos 60 value 1 by 2 equal to OM value. We have to find out OM, so put it as it is, OM by OA. OA value is radius of the circle, that is 12. Now do cross multiplication. 2 into OM equal to 1 into 12 is 12. Now transpose 2 value right side. OM equal to 12 by 2. It is a multiplication, right side in division. So 2 1s are 2 6s are. OM equal to height of the triangle. OM is nothing but height of this triangle. OM equal to 6 centimeters. So OM equal to nothing but height of this triangle equal to 6 centimeters. Now find out base of the triangle AB. See how to find out base of the triangle AB value. Now for this apply sine ratio. Same, sine 60 equal to sine 60 degrees. So sine A formula opposite side by hypotenuse. So opposite side is AM, hypotenuse is OA. So AM by OA. Sine 60 degrees value root 3 by 2 equal to AM value. We have to find out the AM. So put AM as it is, AM by OA value is radius of the circle, that is 12. Now say do the cross multiplication. 2 into AM equal to 2 into AM equal to 12 into root 3. 12 into root 3. See, once again, do cross multiplication. 2 into AM as it is, 12 into root 3. Now transpose to right side. It is a multiplication, right side in division. So AM equal to 12 root 3 by 2. So 2 1s are 2 6s are. AM equal to 6 root 3. AM equal to 6 root 3 centimeters. AM equal to 6 root 3 centimeters. But we need to find the complete length of AB, not AM. So what is the formula?
So what is the formula to find out the complete length AB?
See, AB equal to 2 into AM. 2 into AM, because M is the midpoint. So AM is equal to AB equal to 2 into AM. Now AB equal to 2 into AM value. AM value 6 root 3. 6 into root 3, it is equal to multiply 2 into 6, 12 root 3 centimeter. So length of the
base length AB is equal to 12 root 3 centimeters. Now area of the triangle OAB equal to half into base into height. So it is equal to half into base means AB. Observe here, the base is AB. So AB value 12 root 3 into height. Height of the triangle means OM. OM value is 6 centimeters. So height is 6. See, once again, area of the triangle OAB equal to half into base into height. Base means AB. So AB value 12 root 3. And height means OM. OM value 6.
Now cancel. 2 1s are 2 6. So it is equal to 6 into root 3 into 6. 6 root 3 into 6. So multiply
6 into 6. 6 into 6, 36 root 3.
6 into 6 means 36 root 3. 62.352 centimeter square, because it is area of the triangle.
So 36 root 3 value, 62.352 centimeter square. Now this is area of the triangle OAB. Now find out our required area of the minor segment. See, up to now we calculated area of the sector OXB is 150.72 centimeter square, and just now we calculated the area of the triangle OAB equal to 62.352 centimeter square. Now our required area is area of the minor segment. So area of the minor segment formula, area of sector OAXB minus area of triangle OAB. So this is the formula.
So we need to find out the area of the minor segment AXB. For this, area of the sector complete OAXB, complete this sector, minus eliminate area of the triangle, area of the triangle OAB. If you remove the area of the triangle from the area of the sector, then we get area of the minor segment. So area of the sector formula, area of the sector value 150.72 minus area of triangle OAB equal to 62.352. So its value equal to 88.368 centimeter square. 88.368 centimeter square is our required answer, area of the minor segment.